सो गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन। आई थिंक आप मेरी आवाज सुन पा रहे होंगे। मिस्टर सैयद, हेमांत, दक्ष एंड राहुल, क्या आप मेरी आवाज सुन पा रहे हैं? गुड इवनिंग एवरीवन, क्या आप मेरी आवाज सुन पा रहे हैं बेटा? ओके फाइन। सो इन टुडेज क्लास, फर्स्टली लेट मी इंट्रोड्यूस माई सेल्फ आशीष कर। बेसिकली आई एम फ्रॉम IIT रुड़की एंड सीनियर केमिस्ट्री फैकल्टी फ्रॉम नारायणा द्वारका ब्रांच, राइट बेटा? केमिस्ट्री का बहुत बेसिक चैप्टर अपन लेके चल रहे हैं। इन टुडेज क्लास वी विल डिस्कस अबाउट मोल कॉन्सेप्ट, राइट? वेरी इजी चैप्टर, वेरी सिंपल चैप्टर, वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट चैप्टर एज वेल। आई वॉन्ट कि आप लोग मेरे साथ पार्टिसिपेट करिए। यू हैव टू पार्टिसिपेट विद मी, राइट बेटा? स्टार्ट किया जाए। सो लेट स्टार्ट बेटा, स्टार्ट किया जाए। चलिए स्टार्ट करते हैं। Tell me one thing. What is the meaning of one mole? Can you please tell one mole? What is the meaning of one mole? Yes, please. Sayyad, Hemant, Daksh, Rahul. Please tell me the answer. What is the meaning of one mole? Listen carefully. One mole represent 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 particles. Right? कभी भी मैं आपको बोलूं, you have to take one mole of any compound, then how many particles you will take? You will take 6.022. 10 raised to power 23 particles. Particles can be ions. Particles can be molecules. Particles can be atoms. Particles can be electrons. Particle can be protons. Right, Peter? One mole always represents 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 particles. I think this thing is fine to you. Let us suppose I am saying I have one dozen of something. Then what is the meaning of one dozen? It simply represents 12 units. One dozen simply represents 12 units of anything. Right, sir? Listen carefully. Meri baat ko aap dhyan se suniyega. Let us suppose I am saying you have to take one mole of CO2. Then tell me, one mole of CO2 represent how much molecules, Mr. Sayyad? Tell me the answer. One mole of CO2, you have one mole of CO2. Means how many molecules you have? It represents 6.0 into 10 raised to power 23 molecules. Molecules of CO2. I think you are getting this particular point. This is fine or not? Tell me. This is fine. Let us suppose I have one mole of magnesium atom. Then what is the meaning of one mole of magnesium atom? It represents 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 atom of magnesium. Are you getting this point or not? Tell me. This is fine. Listen carefully. One mole simply represents 6.022 10 raised to power 23 particles. This figure, 10 raised to power 23 particles. This particular figure is also known as Avogadro's number. It is also known as Avogadro's number, represented by Na. This is fine or not? Tell me. Let us suppose I am saying I have 2 mole of CO2. Tell me one thing. How many molecules of CO2 I have? Can you please tell beta? How many molecules of CO2 I have? Yes, please, Hemant, please. How many molecules of CO2 I have? Tell me the answer, beta. Tell me the answer. Tell me the answer, Himan. Mr. Daksh, what's the answer you are getting? 2 mole of CO2 represent how much molecule?
1.044 into 10 power.
2 mole, I am saying it is 2 multiplied by 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23 molecules. Are you getting this point or not? Tell me. This is fine. Can I also write it is nothing? It is equal to 2 multiplied by Na molecules. Because you know Na represent 6.022 into 10 raised to power 23. Is this thing is fine to you? Yes or no? Let us suppose examiner is saying, I have, listen carefully, half mole of H2. Yes, Mr. Rahul, half mole of H2 represent how much molecules? Tell me the answer.
3.011 into 10 to the power 23.
You are 100% correct, beta. It is 3.011 into 10 raised to power 23 molecules. Listen carefully. Molecules of H2. I think this is fine to you. Yes or no, beta? Yes or no? Yes or no? Listen carefully. Let us suppose I have a very easy question. I have 3 mole of CO2. Listen carefully. Now tell me one thing. In 3 mole of CO2, find out the number of carbon atoms. Now you have to tell the answer. What's the answer I will get? 3 mole of CO2 I have, you have to find out the number of carbon atoms. Tell me. Tell me the number of carbon atoms in 3 mole of CO2.
2.
2. Wrong.
Galat. 6, sir.
Yes, 6 is also wrong answer, beta. Yes, anyone else in the class?
3.
Mr. Daksh. Yes, please.
3.
3 carbon atoms. Wrong. Anyone else in the class? Mr. Ashok Kumar, do you want to tell
us? 13, sir.
18.
18, wrong answer.
13.
Sorry?
13,
wrong answer. Anyone else in the class who wants to tell the answer? Mr. Rahul, do you want to tell the answer, beta? Mr. Rahul, do you want to tell the answer? No, sir, I will not tell. Okay, fine. Listen carefully. Can I write one thing? Yadi aapko bura na lage to, 3 moles of CO2 represent 3 multiplied by Na, 3 multiplied by Na molecules of CO2. Tell me this thing is fine to you or not. Tell me. This is fine. Yes or no? This is fine. 3 mole of CO2 means I have 3 multiplied by Na molecules of CO2. Now what I have to find out, I have to find out the number of carbon atoms. So how we can find out? Listen carefully. Let us suppose I have 1 molecule of CO2. Meri baat ko dhyan se suniyega beta. 1 molecule of CO2 I have. Now tell me, In one molecule of CO2, how many carbon atoms I have? Tell me. How many carbon atoms I have? Listen carefully. When you will take the one molecule of CO2, how many carbon atoms it contains? One. Yes or no? Mr. Sayyad, yes or no, beta?
Yes, sir.
One molecule of CO2 represent one carbon atom. Let us suppose I have 2 molecule of CO2. How many carbon atom it contains? Respond kariye. I have 2 molecules of CO2. How many carbon atoms it contains? Tell me the answer.
One
molecule contain one atom, 2 molecule will contain 2 atoms, 3 molecule will contain 3 atoms, 4 molecule will contain 4 atoms. Let us suppose we have 1000 molecule of CO2. 1000 molecule of CO2 contains how much carbon atoms? Tell me the answer. Let us suppose I have 1000 molecule of CO2. How many carbon atoms it contains? Tell me, Sayyar.
Yes, sir.
I have 1000 molecule of CO2. How many carbon atoms I have in 1000 molecule? 1000 carbon atoms. Beta, one molecule contain one atom. Two yes, molecule contain two atom. Three molecule contain three atom. 1000 molecule contain 1000 atom. Right or not?
Yes, sir.
Let us suppose I have 1 crore molecule of CO2. How many carbon atoms I have? 1 crore molecule of CO2. How many carbon atoms I have? 1 crore. Why you are thinking so much? 1 crore carbon atom. Yes or no? Let us suppose I have 10 crore molecule of CO2. In 10 crore molecule of CO2, how many carbon atoms I have? Mr. Himar, 10 crore. Okay, fine. Let us suppose I have 1 mole of CO2. 1 mole of CO2, how many carbon atoms I have?
6.022
into 10 raised to power 23 atoms of carbon. Yes or no? In actual practice, how much moles of CO2 is given? 3 moles of CO2. Now tell me, in 3 moles of CO2, how many carbon atoms I have? Tell me, Das. What you will say, the carbon atoms will be equal to 3 multiplied by Na atoms of carbon. Tell me one thing. Kya aapko ye baat samajh aaya? Are you getting this point or not? Tell me. Respond kariye jaldi. Mr. Sayyad, Himan, Daksh, John. Par ye kya likhe? Pavneesh and Rahul. Are you getting the point or not? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
This is fine. Now, what's the question that I have? In the same question, I have 3 moles of CO2. I have 3 moles of CO2. What you have to do? You have to find out number of oxygen atoms. Can you please tell me the answer? How many number of oxygen atoms I have? Tell me. How many number of oxygen atoms I have? Tell me.
6 into Avogadro's number.
6 multiplied by Avogadro number is 100% correct answer. Mr. Rahul, do you want to tell the answer, beta?
Yes, sir.
What's the answer you are getting? 3 moles of CO2 I have. Tell me, how many oxygen atoms I have? Mr. Sayyar, what's the answer you are getting, beta? What's the answer?
I am getting 0.11.
Kya? Are Sayyad, kya kar rahe ho beta? Suno dhyan se meri baat ko. Meri baat ko dhyan se suno. Okay, fine. Participate with me. Let us suppose I have, let us suppose, one molecule of CO2. Now tell me, in one molecule of CO2, how many oxygen atoms I have? Oxygen atom. Tell me. Two oxygen atom. Yes, Mr. Sayyad, one molecule contain how much oxygen atom?
Two
oxygen atom. Let us suppose I have two molecules of CO2. How many oxygen atom I have?
Four
oxygen atom. Let us suppose I have 1000 molecule of CO2. How many oxygen atom I have? Mr. Sayyad, how many oxygen atoms I have?
Two molecules.
Oh my God. I am saying I have 1000 molecules of CO2. In 1000 molecules of CO2, how many oxygen atom I have? It's 2000, right or not?
Yes, sir.
I have 1 crore molecule of CO2. How many oxygen atom I have?
2 crore.
I have 10 crore molecules of CO2. How many oxygen atom I have?
20
crore. In reality, how much moles of CO2 I have? 3 moles. So in 3 moles of CO2, how many oxygen atoms I have, what you will write? 6 moles of oxygen? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
And 6 moles of oxygen atom I can write, that is 6 multiplied by Na atom. Right or not? Tell me the answer. Right or not? Tell right. me the answer. Right or not? Please, right or not?
Right, sir.
Right, sir. Okay, fine. So, are you ready for the next question? Are you ready for the next question?
Yes, sir.
Find out the total number of atoms in 2 moles of H2SO. Find out the total number of atoms in 2 moles of H2SO. Correctly, you have to tell me the answer. Sochiye aaram se, dimag lagaiye, answer bataiye. 2 moles of H2SO4 I have, and you have to tell me the total number of atoms. जल्दी 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 टेल मी द आंसर, टेल मी द आंसर, बोलो बेटा.
12.044 × 10⁻²³
is wrong answer, बेटा. I am asking the total number of atoms, not molecules.
14.
14. हाँ, ये थोड़ा साउंड अच्छा आ रहा है. Who is saying 14? What's your name, बेटा? I will not tell, sir.
Jashwant.
Jashwant, listen carefully. Listen carefully. 14 atoms or 14 Na atoms? Tell me.
14 Na.
14 Na atoms is the correct answer. Listen carefully. 2 moles of H2SO4 I have. Okay, fine. I can write 2 moles of H2SO4 means 2 multiplied by Na molecules, 2 multiplied by Na molecules of H2SO4 I have. This is given to us, right? Now listen carefully. You have to find out the total number of atoms. How to calculate? Let me tell you. Let us suppose I have 1 molecule of H2SO4. Now tell me, in 1 molecule of H2SO4, how many total atoms I have? Listen carefully. In 1 molecule of H2SO4, how many total atoms I have? What you will say? Sir, it contains 2 hydrogen atoms. It contains 1 sulfur atom. It contains 4 oxygen atoms. Then the total atoms will become 7 atoms. Are you getting this point or not? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
1 molecule contains 7 atoms. Now tell me, 2 molecule will contain how much atoms?
14 atoms.
14 atoms. 1000 molecule contains how much atoms?
7000.
7000 atoms. 1 crore molecule contains how much atoms?
7 crore.
7 crore. Now tell me, 2 Na molecule contains how much atoms?
6.
2 Na molecule.
2 into Na.
Exactly. 2 Na molecule contains how much atoms? देखिएगा बेटा, number of atoms is nothing. That is equal to 2Na multiplied by 7 atoms. Now tell me, are you getting this point or not? Please.
Yes, sir.
What is the final figure that I will get? It is 14 Na atoms. Is this thing is fine to you or not?
Fine, sir.
Right, sir. Are you ready for the next question? Questions ka difficulty level badhta chalega beta. क्वेश्चंस का डिफिकल्टी लेवल बढ़ता चलेगा. मेरी बात को ध्यान से सुन लीजिए. Are you ready for the next question? Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now tell me. Find out. Find out the total number of electrons in 2 mole of O2. Tell me the answer. 2 mole of O2 I have. You have to find out the total number of electrons, right?
Hello, sir.
Yes, please.
So, what you are teaching, sir? I'm new.
I am teaching mole concept. First class for mole concept. Chapter 1, class
11.
Right? Chapter 1, class 11. Mole concept is the chapter. And today's it's the first lecture. We are just discussing what's the relationship between mole and the particle. Yes. Yes, this is
32 Na.
Okay, fine. Anyone else in the class who wants to tell the answer? Anyone else in the class who wants to tell the answer for this one? Find out the total number of electrons in 2 moles of O2. 32 Na is absolutely correct answer. Now let me tell you how we are getting 32 Na. Listen here. मेरी बात सुनिएगा बेटा ध्यान से. मेरी बात सुनिएगा. 2 moles of O2. Can I write 2 moles of O2 is equal to 2 multiplied by Na molecules. Na molecules of O2. Is this thing is fine to you or no? Yes, Sayyad, what's your query, beta? Tell me.
Sir, can you listen one more second question?
Sorry.
This question. Question only. Can you explain?
Yes, I am explaining. I am explaining the same one. I am explaining the same. Right?
Okay.
Right? Okay. Listen. Okay. 2 moles of O2. Can I write 2 moles of O2 is equal to 2 multiplied by Na molecules of O2? Yes, sir. Yeah, this is fine or not? Tell me.
Fine, sir.
Now listen carefully. Let us suppose I have one molecule of O2. Now tell me, in one molecule of O2, how many total electrons I have? Let me tell you. Oxygen contains 8 electrons. Right, Peter? Oxygen contains 8 electrons. And how many oxygen atom I have? 2 oxygen. Means that total electrons in one molecule of O2 is 16 electrons. Yes, Sayyad. Are you getting the point or not, Peter?
Yes, sir.
One molecule of O2 contains 16 electrons. Now tell me, let us suppose I have 1000 molecule of O2. In 1000 molecule of O2, how many electrons I have?
16,000.
Let us suppose I have 1 crore molecule of CO2.
17,000.
Let us suppose I have 1 crore molecule of CO2. Sorry, O2. How many electrons I have? 16 crore. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes or no? In reality, how many molecules you have? 2 Na molecules. Now tell me, in 2 Na molecules of O2, how many electrons I have? What you will write? That is 2 Na multiplied by 32. Sorry, multiplied by 16 electrons. So the correct answer will become 32 Na electrons. Are you getting this point or not, Mr. Sayyad? Please. Sayyad, this thing is fine to you or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. We are moving towards the next question. Listen here. Find out. The total number of electrons, protons and neutrons in 10 moles of water, the isotope I am using for hydrogen, this isotope I am using, for oxygen, this isotope I am using. You have to tell me the answer for this question correctly. You have to tell me the answer for this particular question. Tell me the answer. Aram se sochiye, time lijiye, answer.
Sir, for electrons, 100 Na, sir.
100 Na, yes, your answer is absolutely correct, beta.
Sir, protons, 100 Na, sir.
That's also fine, correct answer.
For neutrons, 80 Na, sir.
Yes, your answer is absolutely correct, beta. Your answer is correct. Aapka answer bilkul sahi, bilkul correct. Okay, fine. What about other students? Mr. Sayyad, Pavneesh, Mr. Aswant, Daksh and Rahul. Tell me your answers.
This answer is correct, sir.
Okay, fine. Listen carefully. Mr. Sayyad, do you want to tell the answer, beta? Mr. Sayyad, do you want to tell? Okay, fine. Find out the number of electrons. Tell me. How many electrons I have? That is equal to 100 Na. Are you getting this answer or not?
Yes, sir.
How
yes,
many
sir.
Of you are getting this answer, Mr. Rahul? Mr. Rahul, are you yes, getting sir. This answer?
Yes,
okay,
yes,
fine.
Sir.
Mr. Daksh, are you getting this answer?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now tell me how many number of protons I have. That is also equal to 100 Na. Is this fine, beta? Yes or no? Okay, fine. Now I have to tell number of neutrons. Number of neutrons will be equal to 80 N. What's the reason behind this? Because
hydrogen
has a zero neutrons. That statement is absolutely correct. So should I move further? Yes, sir. I am moving further. Listen carefully. Sayyad, are you getting the last question or not, Peter? Sayyad, yes, are you getting the last question or not, Peter?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Now tell me the answer. Find out. Find out the mass of electron in 3 moles of carbonate ion.
So what is the mass of one electron, sir?
One electron mass, you can write mass of one electron is equal to 9.11 into 10 raised to power minus 31. This is the mass of one electron.
Into 32 into 3 into Na.
Yes, your answer is looking correct, beta. Your answer is correct, beta. Your answer is correct, beta. Your answer is correct, beta. Yes, anyone else? Abhishek, sir. Abhishek, do you want to tell the answer, beta? Abhishek.
Hello, sir.
Yes.
Sir, it is 9.11 into 10 to the power minus 31 kg into 32 into Na.
Into 32 into Na. One figure is missing, beta. There is one figure that you missed. Can you please tell me the figure?
Yes, sir.
Can you please tell me the figure?
Mole. Yes, sir. That 3 mole part I have missed.
Exactly. Now you are going in right correct, beta. So what is the mass of total electron? Listen carefully. Mass of total electron will be equal to, that is 3 multiplied by Na multiplied by how many total electrons it contains? It contains 32 electrons. What I will get? 32 multiplied by 9.11 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. How many of you are getting this answer? Abhishek, Aswant, Daksh, Pavneesh, are you getting the answer or not, Peter? Yes, Mr. Yes, please, boliye.
Sir, how?
Yes, sir.
How 32 electrons?
Sorry. Okay, fine. How we are getting 32 electrons? Listen.
No, sir. Understood.
Okay, fine. Should I move further? Should I move further? Listen.
Yes, sir.
Find out. Find out the mass of electron, comma, proton, and neutron in 1 mole of let us suppose Mg2+ ion. Think carefully and you have to tell me the answer.
Sir, mass of one proton, how much, sir?
Mass of one proton or neutron, because both have approximately same charge, same mass. Neutron, that is equal to 1.6 into 10 is to power minus 27.
Okay, sir. Sir, mass of electrons, 9.11 into 10 power minus 31 into 14 Na, sir.
Into 14 Na. Oh my god, your answer is not correct, beta.
Sir, 12 Na.
12 Na. Your answer is also not correct, beta.
So magnesium.
10 Na.
Yes, it is 10 Na is the correct answer. In magnesium, I have the total 12 electrons. But in reality, magnesium 2 plus is given. Means two electrons are lost by this magnesium. How many electrons are left? That is 10 electrons. Right, sir? Right or not? But I can write. Yes, Sayyad, what's your query, beta?
Sir, which time we will take?
How we are taking 10? You want to ask this one, right?
Yes, sir.
Okay, fine. Let me tell you. The answer will be 10 multiplied by Na. Multiplied by 9.11 into 10 raised to power minus 31 kg. Now, how we are taking 10? Now, listen carefully. I have magnesium atoms. It contains 12 protons. It contains 12 electrons. But in reality, I have Mg2+. Tell me in Mg2+, in Mg2+, how many protons I have? Protons will be same. How many electrons I have? Electrons will become 10. This 2 positive means, what is the meaning of 2 positive charge? That is, 2 electrons are lost by magnesium atom. And let us suppose I have the negative charge. Negative charge means that much electron is gained by particular atom. Right or not? Sayyad.
Yes, sir.
Sayyad, now can you please tell me what is the mass of proton? Please tell me the answer.
1.66 into 10 power minus 27 into 12 Na.
Yes, your answer is correct, beta. Multiplied by 12 Na. That is the mass of proton. Absolutely correct answer. What is mass of neutron? Let me tell you which isotope of magnesium I am using. Which isotope of magnesium I am using? I am using 12 Mg24. Right, sir. You have to tell me the mass of neutron. Tell me.
1.6 into 10 power minus 27 into 12 Na kg.
Yes, your answer is also correct. Again, correct. 1.6 into 10 is to power minus 27 multiplied by 12 Na kg. Yes, this is absolutely correct answer. This is fine or not? Tell me.
Yes,
this
sir.
Is fine or not? Tell me.
Yes,
okay, fine. So, are you ready for the next question? Are you ready for the next question? Now, I am asking one question from you and you have to tell me the correct answer. Right, Peter? 10 moles of H2SO4. I have. the first question. Number of H atoms. Second question. Number of sulfur atoms. Third question. Number of oxygen atom. Fourth question. Number of electrons. Fifth question. Number of protons. Sixth question. Number of neutrons. Now what you have to tell, the next question is, that is, seventh question, it is mass of proton. I think screen is visible to all of you. Yes or no, beta? Eighth question, mass of electron. Ninth question, mass of neutron. And the last question is charge on the molecule. Charge on the molecule. Now these are the 10 questions and you have to tell me the answer. Think carefully, then you have to tell me the answer. Think carefully.
So show the question, sir.
Okay, fine. Sorry. Yes, please tell me the answer, beta.
Sir, I am not getting the answer.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine.
Sir, can I know what is the atomic number of sulfur?
Okay, fine. Just wait a minute. This is hydrogen. This is sulfur. And this is oxygen, right, Peter? Atomic number of sulfur is 16. Alina, do you want to tell the answer, beta? I think this topic is not new to you, right, beta?
Sir, actually, there is a problem with the app link which I have shared on my SMS.
Okay, fine. Okay, fine.
You have, in digital group, give me a link, ID and password, which is others, because I log in with that and the name, phone number, address, all are different from my address.
Okay, fine.
Sir, is this not demo class?
Yes, it's a demo class.
Yes, sir. So in normal classes, how much persons will be there? Now we are 7 to 8. In normal classes, how much there will be?
Generally, in normal classes, we have max 30 to 40 students. Not more than that. Because personal interaction is more important, right?
Yes, sir.
These are the maximum students I am saying.
Oh.
When we will be there?
Sorry?
Max period, when will be there?
It will be updated to you, right, Peter?
Okay, sir.
Now you have to focus on your question and tell me the answer.
Sir, number of hydrogen atom, 1.
No, beta.
2 hydrogen atoms.
Sorry, sir, 2. Is it 2?
No, beta. In 10 moles of...
20 Na.
20 Na.
Yes, 20 Na is looking to be the correct answer.
Second one, 10 into Na.
Second one is 10 into Na. Okay, fine.
Third one, 40 Na.
That's fine.
Fourth one, 82 into 10 into Na. That is 820
Na. Number of electrons, 82. I think that is not correct.
Fourth one, 500 into Na.
Yes, your answer is again correct, beta.
Fifth one, 500 into Na.
Correct answer. Next one.
Sixth one, 480 into Na.
That's
please show
fine.
Down, sir.
That's fine. Okay, fine.
Sixth one,
480
into Na.
Listen carefully. The number of hydrogen atoms are how much? That is equal to. That is equal to 20 multiplied by Na. Right? Yes, Alina, are you getting this answer? Himant, that's fine. Ashwant, are you getting this answer or not, Peter?
Yes, sir. I got it.
Alina, are you getting this answer or not?
Actually, I didn't see the number 10.
Okay,
fine. I have joined now, so I didn't see the number 10.
Okay, fine. I have the 10 moles of H2SO4. Now it is fine, 20 Na?
Yes, sir.
Number of sulfur atoms is 10 Na. Number of oxygen atoms is 40 Na. Number of electrons are 500 Na. Number of protons are, that is also 500 Na. Number of neutrons are 480 Na. What is the mass of proton? That is equal to 500 Na multiplied by 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 27.
Sir, can you explain how 480 Na becomes the answer of number of neutrons?
How we are getting number of neutrons? Okay, fine. I will tell. Just wait a minute. What is the mass of electron? It is 500 Na multiplied by 1.6 into 10 is, 9.1 into 10 is to power minus 31. What is the mass of neutron that I will get? What is the mass of neutron? That is equal to, 480 Na multiplied by 1.6 into 10 is to power minus 27 kg. What is the charge on the molecule? It will be 0. So how we are getting the number of neutrons? Listen carefully. Dhyan se meri baat ko aap log suniye. How we are getting the number of neutrons? Listen carefully, beta. H2SO4 I have. 10 moles of H2SO4 I have. 10 moles of H2SO4 means 10 multiplied by Na molecules I have. Yes, I think this thing is fine to you. Any doubt, Peter? Any doubt?
This is fine.
Now listen carefully. Let us suppose I am assuming one molecule of H2SO4. Now you have to tell me in one molecule of H2SO4, how many neutrons I have. Hydrogen is the only element which contains zero neutrons. Right, Peter? Or in the previous classes, in class 9th, 10th, I think you studied about this, how to find out the number of neutrons. That is equal to atomic mass minus atomic number. Alina, this is fine to you, Vita?
Yes, sir. Got it.
Hydrogen, we have the zero neutron. In sulfur, I have the 16. In oxygen, I have 8. But total oxygen, I have 4. That is 8 multiplied by 4. It is 32. So that is equal to 48 neutrons. I think this thing is fine too. This is fine, beta. Yes or no?
Got it, sir.
Okay, fine. I am moving further. Listen carefully. Now there is one question that is completely of different type question. You have to tell me the answer. Listen carefully. Find out. Find out the charge on one mole of sodium ion. One mole of sodium ion. I have. You have to find out the charge. Right.
One plus.
Oh my God! Do you think I will ask such a easy question? No. Right. It's a very tricky question. Such type of question still did not come in IIT exam, but in future definitely it will come. Find out the charge on one mole of sodium ion. A very important.
Sir, that is Na plus plus one electrons gives Na, so the charge will be one Faraday.
No.
Avogadro.
The charge will be how much?
One Faraday.
Yes, your answer is looking correct, Peter. Your answer is correct. One Faraday. Oh my God. Anyone else in the class who wants to tell the answer? But I think one Faraday, you don't have to tell the answer to be one Faraday because the charge is not due to electron, right? The charge is due to the protons. That is what I want to say. The answer will comes out to be one Faraday, but the charge is not due to electron, it is due to proton. That is what I want to tell.
So answer would be in Coulomb.
Yes?
Answer would be in Coulomb, no?
That's fine. Answer will be in Coulomb. Then what's the answer? Oh, sir, I will not tell. Please, beta, please tell me the answer, please. Tell me the answer.
1.602 10^-19 coulomb.
Okay, fine. Tell me the answer. What's the answer you are getting, beta? What's the answer? Listen here. The question is very tricky as well as important. Yes, Sayyed, do you want to tell the answer?
No, sir. You.
Okay, fine. Listen carefully. One mole of sodium ion I have, one thing which I can write, one mole of sodium ion is equal to 6.022 into 10^23 ions of sodium. I think this is fine to you. Yes or no, beta? Yes or no? Which I can also write, I have Na ions of sodium. Is this thing is fine to you? Tell me. Tell me, is this thing is fine to you?
Yes, sir.
This thing is fine to you. Okay, fine. Listen carefully. Let us suppose I have sodium atom. In sodium atom, can you please tell how many protons I have? 11 protons. How many electrons I have? 11 electrons. Right, Peter? But in reality, I have sodium ion, Na plus ion. Positive charge means sodium is losing one electron. Yes or no, beta? Yes or no? Now listen carefully. In sodium ion, I have 11 protons and I have 10 electrons. Is this thing is fine to you? Tell me. Now listen carefully. In sodium ion, I have 11 protons, 10 electrons. So the resultant charge on sodium ion will be due to electron or proton. Tell me. There is one extra proton in sodium ion and we are not considering neutron because neutron has the zero charge. So what I want to ask from you, I have 11 protons and 10 electrons. So the charge one positive is due to electron or proton. You have to tell me. Proton. Now tell me on one sodium ion, the charge is due to one proton. Is this thing is fine to you? Yes or no? Main jawab dijiye. Yes or no? Charge is due to one proton on one sodium ion. Yes or no? Yes or no? Yes or no? बोलो यार क्या गड़बड़ हो रही
है? Can you repeat once more?
बिल्कुल listen carefully. I have sodium ion. In sodium plus, I have 11 protons and 10 electrons, right? As you know, electron has the negative charge, proton has the positive charge, neutron do not have any charge. I am asking, I want to find out the resultant charge. So the resultant charge will be due to proton or electron. Obviously due to proton, because proton is one more than s compared to electron. Yes or no, Alina? Alina, are you getting this point or not, beta? I think you are not getting this point. You are getting this point or not?
Got it.
Got it. Okay, fine. 11 protons and 10 electrons. Resultant, how much protons will be left? One proton will be left. Means the charge on one sodium ion will be due to one proton. Because 10 protons charge will be cancelled out by 10 electrons charge. Right or no? So I can write, charge is due to one proton on one sodium ion. And what is the charge on one proton? It is 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. Yes or no? Yes or no? Tell me.
Yes, sir.
This is fine. Now listen carefully. On one sodium ion, the charge is due to one proton and that figure is equal to 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. But in reality, how many sodium ions I have? Na sodium ions. So on Na sodium ions, the total charge will be due to Na protons. And what is the total charge I will get? Na multiplied by charge on proton is how much? 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. No doubt, when you will solve this figure will comes out to be 1 Faraday. That's fine. That's not the issue. But the charge positive represents the charge due to proton, not due to electron. Right, sir? Right or no? Tell me.
Got it, sir.
Sayyad, Hemant, Ashwanath, and Daksh, Pavneesh, Rahul. Are you getting the answers or not, beta?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. So,
in this way, we can easily calculate the charge. In today's class, what we discussed basically, number of atoms, number of molecules, number of electrons, number of protons, number of neutrons, mass of electron, mass of proton, mass of neutron. And the last one is how to find out? Hum nahi bolenge, hum naraaz hai aapse.
Charge.
I have 2 mole of Mg2+. Now you have to find out the total charge. Jaldi. Total charge is equal to how much? Oh ho, bolo, 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 bolo. Total charge, 2 moles of Mg2+ I have. Dhyan se batana beta answer. Galat bataya na to dikkat ho jayega. Chali, sochi.
So 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 into 2 into Na. Am I right?
No. You are missing one figure, beta.
4 into Na into 1.6 into 10 power minus 19 C.
Absolutely correct. Bilkul sahi. Basically, Ashwanath, what I am using, two moles. I am not using one mole. Two moles mean I have two Na molecules. And the charge is two positive means due to two protons. That is multiplied by 2 into 1.6 into 10 raised to power minus 19 coulomb. Yes, Ashwanath, are you getting the Ashwant, are you getting the point or not?
Yes, sir.
Sayyad, are you getting the point? Hemant, Alina, Daksh, Pavni, are you getting the point or not, beta?
Mr. Rahul.
So this thing is fine to you? So this is all about how to find out the charge. right? So this is all about your today's class. So next class mein milte hain, next trial class mein milte hain. This is the first class for the mole concept. It's completely the trial class. So we will meet in the next class. Filhal ke liye apna dhyan rakhiyega.
Sir, is this class means this portion is of 11th class?
Yes, this is the 11th class chapter 1, right?
Okay,
so fine.
How much trial classes we will get?
Okay, it will be updated time to time to you, right? It will be updated to you, right?
Okay,
fine. We will meet in the next class. Apna dhyan rakhiye, take care. Bye.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you everyone. Have a good day. Thank you.